altar of God. You are the dwelling place of God among men. You are the ladder by which angels and archangels descend down to us. You are the factory where the holiest sacrament on earth is formed. You are the site where the Holy Spirit dwells on the bread and wine. You are the safest place where one runs for protection from death. You are the spot whenever we stand in are considered to be standing in heaven. So, altar of God, why do I see you so lonely? Why don't I hear the word, offer, offer, look towards the altar? Why am I not allowed to kiss you, hug you, or bow down under your steps? Why I don't see the priests offering incense before you? Was Jeremiah the prophet who was speaking about me when he said, reform your ways and your actions, and I will let you live in this place. Do not trust in deceptive words and say, this is the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord. Altar of God, why have you prevented me from approaching? I almost hear you saying, because you entered the altar carelessly. You approach me with your hands filled with deceit. You kissed me while your lips are like Judas. You take off your shoes so you don't dirty my place. I wish you had kept your shoes on, so at least you would have known how you made me feel. How you made me feel when you don't take off the attire of hate, when you don't take off the hardness of your heart, when you don't let go of your pride, when you don't let go of your hypocrisy. Listen to what the prophet Jeremiah said about you and others like you. Will you steal and murder, commit adultery and perjury, burn incense to Baal, and follow other gods you have not known, and then come and stand before me in this house which bears my name and say, we are safe, safe to do all these detestable things? But, altar of God, this is a hard saying. Who can understand it? My son, you answered, does this offend you? Are you sad for the closure of the sanctuary? Are you hurt by the absence of liturgies? Are you disappointed by the lack of hymns? Are you frustrated because you don't enjoy the smell of the incense? Then hear what the prophet Jeremiah says. Has this house, which bears my name, become a den of robbers to you? How many times did you enter for communion and were not prepared? How many times did you take communion and had not forgiven those who offended you? How many times did you eat the body of the Lord and were not discerning? How many times did you eat the body of the Lord while you were hurting the bodies of others? How many times did you drink from the blood of the Lord and you were not repentant? How many times did you drink from the blood of the Lord while you were slaughtering others? How many times did you sing that your heart was with the Lord but did not comprehend? Woe to me! Let the mountains and the rocks fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne, from the wrath of the Lamb. Altar of God, what do I do then? Listen to me. If you want to return to worshiping by the sanctuary and go back to liturgy, listen to what Jeremiah the prophet said. If you really change your ways and your actions and deal with each other justly, if you do not oppress the foreigner, the fatherless, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, and if you do not follow other gods to your own harm. Altar of God, I say with Jonah the prophet, I have been cast out of your sight, but I love you. No, I adore you. I cannot live without you. Since I was formed, I loved you. Since I learned how to speak, I conversed with you. I do not deserve to touch you, but let me stay by your doorstep. I do not deserve to eat from my master's table, but let me eat from the fragments that may fall. Altar of God, please, I beg you, do not prevent me from kneeling down by your steps. My son, if you want to come back to your place in the sanctuary, listen to what Jeremiah the prophet is saying. If you really change your ways and your actions and deal with each other justly, if you do not oppress the foreigner, the fatherless, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, and if you do not follow other gods to your own harm, then I will let you live in this place, in the land I gave your ancestors forever and ever. Altar of God, I have no power to ask. I have no courage to repent. But please, help me to return back to kneel down by your steps. Let me say with Jonah the prophet, yet I will look again toward your holy temple. Yes, I will look again toward your holy temple. Please, Lord, let me look again toward your holy temple.